This is a code walkthrough for the example file ObjectReferences.java. Let's open up this file in JGrasp and take a look. So the purpose of this file is to demonstrate the idea of object references and the idea that object references point to actual data in memory and that data in memory can be pointed to by multiple object references. So as always, let's start by compiling the file, and it compiles cleanly. We'll set a breakpoint and start single stepping our way through this. So let's say that we've set up two object references for two CS12 dates, today and tomorrow. Once we instantiate these objects as we do here, we've got two complete dates of the specified days, October 1st and October 2nd. And we'll just print those out using the implicit to string. So what we're going to do here is we're going to set the two dates equal to each other. We're going to equate their object references. And what we'll see now is that the object reference for today now points to or has the same data as tomorrow. So notice that today has changed and it exactly matches tomorrow's day. The only thing that changed was the day. The month and the year were already identical. And so now both of these objects are the same. So notice that if we change tomorrow's day, today is going to come along for the ride because both today and tomorrow are pointing to the same body of data. So we change tomorrow, but today changed as well. And we can do the converse with today. We'll set the day for today equal to 28. And notice that tomorrow followed in suit. And these are the current states of the two dates. Now, if we want to get rid of an object, we said that we could set its object reference equal to null. So we'll do that here with tomorrow. And notice that this data is about to evaporate. So tomorrow is ready to be reclaimed by the JVM. So we can still print out today. But if we try to do something, and we can actually still print out tomorrow as well, we can print a null value. That's fine. But if we want to try to do something with tomorrow by using one of its methods, we can't. We can't what's called dereference a null value. We can't apply the next day method to a null. Because if we try to, we're going to get this null pointer exception. This is our sign that something has gone wrong in Java. If we try to free run this file, notice that we're going to get the same error. So if you want this to free run all the way through, you're going to need to comment out that line, recompile it, and then it'll run to completion. So in summary, this example just shows that multiple object references can point to the same body of data.